Don't you people have manners?
Happy decorum, sir.
Yeah. Go write a complaint. Take out again.
Taking you in, Connor. Dead or alive.
I'm sorry, Inspector. No can do. No bullets. The game's over, Inspector. But mine has just begun.
For my son! That's right, smirk away, silly old man. Hope you want a trip to a nursing home real soon.
Pepper, shush! Girl, bad dream. Come on, let's get some rest.
Morning, Frank.
Zero.
Nothing for me.
Keep it. Don't know why I bother.
Hey, too bad about your neighbor, huh?
What you mean?
Didn't you hear? A week ago, they took him to the hospital. Stroke.
Is that right? So, who gets his mail?
Don't know. I take it to the office.
Is he bad?
No, they don't tell us these things.
Yeah. Bless it, Dick.
Same to you, Rob.
Is everything all right in there?
It's a damn dog. I don't know what to do with him.
What do you mean?
I don't have a place for him. He's got to go.
Go? Where?
Out. Everything is going out.
Is he dead?
The dog?
No, the loony.
Bernie? No, they're going to move him.
Where?
A nursing home. I don't know. I heard he have no family, nothing. And why do you care? Don't you have enough complaints from him in the office?
He's got a son, I'm sure. Twice a week, he gets a letter from him, waves it in front of me like a rattle to a top.
And what can I tell you? Parents get sick, kids disappear, and I gotta go.
Wait. Open the door. I'll take the dog. Hello, dog. I don't know your name. I'm Earl. Your neighbor. To come over for a snack. Earl here.
Detective Wilson. Almost 9 years and the badge doesn't come off.
What you got?
Nothing. No son, no wife, no relatives of any kind. Wife died in 96, son in 82.
82?
He was 10. Who is this guy?
Yeah. Who is this guy?
You're funny.
Good to hear your voice too, Fran.
Here's to Earl. If you need something.
I know. Blessed day, Fran.
You too, Earl.
Good old Earl's gone mad. What the hell am I gonna do with you? You gotta have a relative somewhere.
Mr. Friedman? Mr. Friedman? Great news. Your niece is here. I know how excited you must be. She will be taking you home. I'm gonna grab his wheelchair, then I'll help you get him dressed. Just take it easy, okay? Don't get him too excited.
Okay. Yes, Uncle. I feel the same way. Conspiracy. Kidnapping. Accomplice in aiding and abetting. Anything else I can assist you with?
Well, I'd offer you some lasagna, but I think we're gonna have to settle for Chinese.
Thanks, I'm full. The social worker has all my info.
Good.
I have a gun and a badge, you know.
Well, don't turn yourself in. Fran. Thank you.
Blessed day, Earl.
I'm not a good cook. I don't have a degree in nursing. And I got a very short temper. So you best behave. But you don't like rice? Good for you. I don't eat without my music either. All right, champ. Looking good. Let's hit the showers. I bet you never thought you'd have a black man washing you in your bathtub. Well, I sure didn't have this on my wish list. What, are we going for a walk or to a fashion parade? Don't even. That's it. Out. Did you not hear me knocking? You still on that damn thing? What, you got a girlfriend or something? That look in your eyes. Oh, guess what? Jazz Alley just called. We got the best table in the house. Forgotten, right? You better not. See you 4:30 sharp on my doorstep.
Yeah. Now that's what I'm talking about. You ready for the boys' night out? Earl here.
Earl.
Fran, blessed evening.
Bad news. Social worker's on the way.
It's almost 5 now.
They just called.
They were just here last week.
Not sure how to tell you this. Someone wrote a complaint on you. I'm sorry.
It had to be today. Not yesterday. Not tomorrow. But today. All right. Let's go. This is how Daddy's spending his birthday. Then his girl's coming with him.
Surprise!
Midnight, you wake up all alone, lying in the dark and listening for the phone, hoping he'll call and say, "Hey babe, I'm on my way and it's midnight." And there's not a single sound, just as the hands roll round, you think a hand you used to hold, whose touch has since grown cold, and it's midnight. Midnight, you wonder, yeah, you do, where it all went wrong, and who's replacing you. Midnight, you're lying there awake, wondering how much you're heart can't take. It's midnight. You start pushing for the dawn, even knowing when that sun comes up he'll be just as gone, cause it's a waste of good moonlight when your love is out of sight, and it's midnight.